Think back, what is the first video game you ever played? What was it? Do you remember? Anyone? You?
I do.
What is this game launched 35 weeks in a row? Woo. Damn. And it's just us three, the original three, as Sally said earlier. Mm-hmm. Right? I kind of feel like, I mean, Dosha, you joined a little bit later on. Do you remember exactly when you joined something? On Game Lounge?
But I think I joined around like 17. I was a guest then, but it counts, right?
Yeah.
17?
17.
Man, the weeks fly by.
They do.
Sally, they do. But Sally, this was your idea. This is a special Game Lounge. What are we doing here? Can you explain what happened?
Asked you last week, all you guys, to ask us questions for us to make up a Game Lounge. Off of all your questions, we're not going to talk about any topics we found out this week at all, hopefully.
That's right. So if this podcast bombs, all you got to do is pull out a mirror and look, and that's who you blame. Or you can fight in the comment section. Why did you ask that stupid question? That was stupid, man. But we picked out we're going to try and answer as many comment questions from the last one. But we picked out a few that we definitely want to respond to. So what is Sally, do we have anything to promote? I probably should have talked about this before.
No, we're just promoting the fact that this is your podcast, you guys.
Yes. And I think for now, we're going to take at least like one or two questions from the comments from now on. I mean, but this one's all about you guys. But, you know, for now on, we're going to take a couple. So definitely leave a question for next week. So did we decide what's the first thing we want to get into? Oh!
Yeah, we did. Yeah, Dr. Samich, PhD. I like that name, Dr. Samich. He asked us what the first game we ever played was. So, what is it?
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead, Sally.
Mine is Duck Hunt.
Duck Hunt?
Yeah.
The classic.
Yeah. Did you do that thing where you take the gun and then you stick it right up to the television? And
oh my god, yeah. You know, I actually I made a commentary like a while ago and I talked about that. I was a young kid. I fucking went up to the fucking tube. The tube. Remember the tube television? with the glass thing. Yeah, I cheated like that. That was before Game Shark, y'all.
Oh god. Did you try to shoot the dog, though?
I don't remember a dog. I just remember you mean just a normal dog?
No.
Damn, the dog that laughs, you know, the one in the bushes when you fail?
No, I don't remember that.
You pop, so that piece of crap dog. Everybody remembers that dumb dog.
I was really young, and I just remember shooting ducks, okay?
You know what it is? You know what it is? She was too good. She never had, the dog never popped up. That's what happened.
Oh. Yeah, there was this little dog that used to pop up down the bottom. But yeah, you guys, I don't even know if you can play. I know you can play a bunch of games on like ROM emulators and stuff. Pretty much all the Nintendo games are like free now. I don't know if that's legal or not, but you can't buy a Nintendo system anymore. So I'm pretty sure you could download all the ROMs for like a Nintendo, a Super Nintendo, Sega, and all that stuff. I don't know, how would you even play Duck Hunt now? Because you actually need a gun for that, the little light gun.
They made it a little cheap, actually. You could just use the mouse to kind of scroll over the duck and hit it. It's lame. It's not the same thing, you know?
Yeah. I actually didn't like that game. The dog pissed me off when he'd laugh at me. I like Mario. I fucking loved Mario Bros., dude. And I loved it so much. And I liked Luigi because he was green. And I would like purposely put in two quarters because my family was too broke to actually buy me a Nintendo. So I would put in two quarters, I would let Mario die on purpose, and then I would try to pass the game as Luigi because no one ever used Luigi. So yeah, it would probably be Mario Bros. I mean, eventually I was always a generation behind, so I had a Nintendo and everyone had a Super Nintendo. Then I had a Super Nintendo when everyone had a, what was the next one? N64?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I never even had a fucking N64 after that. So, but yeah, prior Mario Bros. I guess the first, I mean, he's asking the first game we played, like, actually.
Yeah, first
played.
Game.
Yeah, I don't think that's from Mikey. He's probably gonna go Atari or something like that.
Well, that's different then, because like my uncle, I remember going to my uncle's house as a little kid, and he had like one of those handheld things, like really old school, and I don't even know what it was, but it's like a football, old school football game.
Oh god!
I don't remember the name of it, but I was a little kid, and he had one of those, and then he did have an Atari, but I vaguely remember it. I was like five or something. I remember the Atari thing, because you can't forget something like that. It was like, wow, this is cool. I'm controlling the joystick. Actually, now that I think about it, maybe he was playing, and then he just handed me the controller, making me think I was playing.
Oh snap!
I don't know. But the first game I really like was Mario Brothers. But I mean everyone liked that one. What about you, Dosha? What was your?
See, honestly, I don't remember exactly which one of these two was the first games. But you guys are gonna be like, wow, it wasn't even Sega or Super Nintendo that I started with. It was actually a PC game and an arcade game. I don't remember which one I played first, but I know I played Commander Keen 4 for the PC. Way back, and that was one of my first games. And then the other one was I remember going to my grandfather's house. We lived in the projects, but for some reason he had an arcade cabinet on his back porch.
What?
Yeah, he was it's rich. Crazy.
He was
yeah, okay. he was balling, and he had this game called Off Road, and it was
fuck, I remember that.
Yeah, you remember that? Yeah, and it was just three steering wheels, and that's all it was. And
shit, your uncle's loaded, dude.
I know.
Are you kidding me? That's like a $10,000 game back then.
That's what I played, and I remember those two games I would play religiously, just Off-Road and Commander Keen. And those were two completely different kind of games, but those were what got me into video games. And then I got my first console, which was actually a Sega Genesis. Not a Super Nintendo, so I came into Mario late. But
did people make fun? Did Nintendo people make fun of you for having a Sega?
No, you mean see, I was in the hood, so I was the only one with video games. To be honest.
No, so they couldn't really make. Everybody else was playing GTA in real life.
Yeah, their real life GTA. People weren't really up on video games until they came to my house, or my grandfather's house, and we all played stuff. You know, it kept us out of trouble.
Even today, if you're to own a cabinet, like a fucking arcade system, that's a lot of money, dude. They've always cost so much.
Yeah.
I never quite understood that. I mean, it's a big piece of plywood, and then you have the components inside. It really should be a little bit more than a computer, maybe $1,500, I would think. But for whatever reason, I remember, they go for like $5,000 and shit. And if your grandpa had that shit brand new, damn, he was loaded.
Yeah,
because that was a four-person game with four steering wheels. That was a big-ass cabinet. He could have been charged. Or was it your grandpa? You said
my grandfather. Yeah,
he could have been.
But he was rich though. He owned a few grocery stores and a couple of apartment complexes. Like that neighborhood, that was his.
He probably dropped. You know. I'm gonna estimate he dropped $15,000 on that on that machine. He could have been charging kids nickels on that, and they would have been lining up. That was a beast. Game back in the day, it was awesome.
It was cool, and I mean, I didn't know any better. I didn't really think to notice how ridiculous it was, because I remember, you know, it had three wheels, it had steer wheels, had the foot pedals, and then we would all just huddle around the TV. We would just race each other. I'd lose all the goddamn time, but I remember playing that game. It was so much fun. That was great.
Yeah, those games were the four player ones. I know the Simpsons had one. Ninja Turtles. There was like a WrestleMania one.
that was my favorite.
You can still go to a lot of arcades, and they have them. They will still have them, because there hasn't. Once, you know, I mean, consoles and PCs they're just more popular. Like, who goes to arcades now? You know, so there's like a lot of old school shit. Like, there's always Pac-Man. You can guarantee there's always a fucking Pac-Man. I think there's always Mario Brothers. There's always these old ass games, but they're fun to play though. Mm-hmm. It's fun to go old That's school. True.
Miss them.
So we ready for the next one, Sally?
Yes. What, are you making me read the next one?
Yeah.
Uh-oh, is it inappropriate?
No. I'm gonna pick this one since it's the next one.
Okay.
So Tim Reid Maximum Sparx and Stephen Quillin, I noticed, asked about this one topic. They all asked.
I know it's a heavy one. It's about... I don't know if you're allowed to say that word, Sally.
No. Racism. It's about racism.
Okay.
And I think it was Maximum. Was it either Maximum or Tim asked about the N-word, and they're saying that, you know, being called when I was younger.
Yeah. Called a what?
You want to read it? I'll read it. I can read it. I get a pass. All right. Being called a nigga when I was younger, it honestly made me feel terrible. That wasn't really structured as a question, but I understand.
Mm-hmm. All right. So one of those, because a lot of people were asking about racism. So it was either Tim, Maximum, or Steven. They got called a... I feel like you, Sally. They got called an N-word. Oh my goodness. Who was it? Was it Tim or Maximum? It was probably Maximum. No. Well, Sally, that leaves us out. Have we been? Actually, I think I have on Xbox Live. I've been called a Jew, a nigga. I've been called all kinds of stuff. Cunt, whore, everything. You called everything, but I don't think that really counts.
See, what I want to know, I'm curious, is...
That is so... Go on.
Has he been called this to their face?
I don't know.
Is this an online thing? Like, I think it needs a little more explanation.
We can address it online-wise, or I think even in real life, because that happens. And it's not just secluded to just the N-word, it's just racism in general, too.
Right.
I'm going on my Instagram right now. I've been called. I'm pretty sure I've been called a nigger Jew. I'm looking it up. When I get called these weird names, I take. I was called. Hold on, I take pictures of them because you're just so funny. Oh no, I've been called a faggot. Yeah, that's happened a lot of times.
So I just booted up my Xbox and looked at my messages. I get called that shit all the time.
But I've definitely been called that. Is Jew? I wish we had a Jewish person here. I'm sorry. Why is Jew? I'm so ignorant. Why is Jew a bad word? Is that bad to say Jew? Yeah, someone called me a fucking Jew. You're not even good.
I don't know what does someone's religion has to do with how they are.
I think that's racist, and I'm not a racist person. I'm just repeating that. The things that people call me. That's just words. And I would like to think that when people call you the N-word or the J-word or the whatever word, it's just someone, like, reaching. They're reaching for their straws. They're just trying to get something to get under your skin.
Yeah.
You really shouldn't feel terrible. He says, honestly, it made me feel terrible.
I wouldn't. Huh. I'd be, you know...
Go on.
I'm black. I fucking love it. I love my black ass skin. It's great. It really, personally, I've been called that a lot. When people call me that, I feel sorry.
Hold up. In real life or on Xbox Live?
Both. I can call it both.
The fuck? Wow.
How do you deal with it? What about in real life, though?
In real life, we live in such a fucking politically correct world. People always try to dance around the N-word and say things that kind of correlate to it. Instead of just call me a straight-up nigga. I think that's more offensive.
I find that... Okay.
Because...
I'm sorry. I find that very hard to believe. That's when in real life, you're just hanging out at the store and someone just randomly comes up to you and says the N-word to you.
No. That's what I'm saying. They'll never just walk up and say it. Not directly. We don't live in that world anymore where people do that. The most part, not up here. But people will always insinuate. They'll always hint at it. They'll always, you know, kind of make a reference to the fact that I am black in some way, shape, or form. I had this post. I can't find it anymore. It is an article about how racism is. Like, you ever heard the term "you people"?
Yeah.
In context with a lot of stuff.
You people, remember that from that freaking movie?
In reference to a lot of things, like I'm just gonna make that general reference because I don't want to go too deep into it. But like, you know, you'll probably hear stuff like that, and then you'll hear it in reference to a lifestyle thing that they might want to do. Like, for example, no matter where I go, no matter what I'm doing, I always have a discussion about chicken, watermelon, and waffles.
Waffles.
And God, don't let it get to fucking Kool-Aid, because then it'll start, and no one will ever say the flavor. I know the flavors. It's grape, it's red cherry, there's tropical part. Motherfucker! Like, come on now. Why you gotta say red to me all the time? Which one? There's a lot of red flavor. All
right. I've said this before. If you don't, okay, fried chicken is fucking good as fuck.
Everybody loves
fried chicken. If you don't like fried chicken, and if you don't like Kool-Aid, any flavor, doesn't matter, except for lemonade flavor. Why the fuck are you drinking lemon Kool-Aid? You just have fucking lemonade. And watermelon is good. You can put salt on it. A lot of people don't know about that. You can put salt on it. It tastes kind of good. What's that's? There's something wrong with you. Why would you not like those things? That I don't get that. That's what I don't get. What you don't
I
like?
I should also bring up.
So what
you don't? Sally eat? Did mention.
Hmm? Which what happened?
She mentioned something. Sally did mention something. This is brand new because of Dave Chappelle. Everybody says grape drink. I can't stand that shit. I don't drink grape drink. I don't know what juice or drink.
I thought it was purple drink. Okay.
Purple drink. I don't give a shit. I'm tired of hearing that. Like, yo, you know what? Kale fucked us up with orange soda, and then motherfuckers thought black people love orange soda for a long ass time. Then punk ass Dave Chappelle come in, fucking all everybody talking about grape drink, purple drink. God damn it, motherfucker! I like water. Alright?
Fat-free
water.
I don't know. I don't know where that came. The grape drink thing came from. I mean, it's good for mixing up with like vodka or something, but otherwise, it just turns your poo a different color.
I like pineapple juice. And
Oh, that is good. Mm-hmm. But it's hard to find.
Oh, not in the grocery store.
No, looking. I haven't seen it. Trust me, I would get it. If I seen a big-ass jug of pineapple drink. Wait, are you talking about pineapple drink or pineapple juice?
Juice.
Oh, that would be expensive because pineapples are expensive. It's not like apple juice.
True. Very true.
All right. Did we answer the question? He feels terrible.
Well,
Sally, has anyone been... racist towards you?
Of course.
Okay, good talk. I can believe it. No, you didn't. Sally made a commentary. You made a commentary about being Asian, and I, until you made that commentary, and we will have a link to it, I had no idea that Asians were so, what's the word? They were so, they had so many racial things. I mean, I kind of did.
I feel like they get abused the most.
But yeah. I didn't understand the level of it. So what happened? People say things about Asians, right?
Yeah, they say a lot of things. And the first one that can ring like in the back of my head is always when I was a child.
Uh-oh, is she cutting out for you?
Differences in each other, right?
Wait. You cut out.
I think the... What?
You cut out just a little bit. What was the first thing people would say?
I was saying the first thing that people would do is point out the differences in each other, and that's where racism comes from, you know? And I think for me, the first thing that comes to mind is like, people would make fun of me when I was really young about my eyes. They're like, why are they, you know, they'll either say they're slanted or they're like, why do you have such small eyes? Which I don't know how that is possible because my eyes are almond shaped, okay?
but that's children, though, I mean.
I know. And then, you know, as you grow up, that does happen all the time. You know, even now to this day and age, I'll either get made fun of because I'm Asian or, you know, they'll say, oh, you know, do you like Asian guys because they have small penises? You know, those stereotypes, which, you know, we can laugh here and there, especially now that I'm older. But, you know, for younger kids, like, just like whoever is asking the question about, you know, the N-word, we know how to deal with it now because we're so used to it. You know, I don't know if that's a good thing, you know? Yeah. But that's mainly what it is.
Yeah. What about you, Mikey?
No, I haven't gotten any of those types of things, but in case you haven't noticed, I have kind of a soft voice. I don't have exactly the deepest voice. Newsflash. And so I get called a fag all the time and all these things.
Really? Me too?
I highly doubt that, dude. But, it's just words. And anybody who says shit to me in person, they just gotta deal with what happens. I, I, I'll admit it, like, I'll get in fights. I'll fight you. It's not the best thing to do, but I will fight you. I will fight anybody, and it's bad. It's really bad. So, Mr. Tim or Maximum or Steven, you should take some boxing classes or something if it comes down to that. Learn how to listen, the world ain't sunshine and rainbows, and I think every kid should take like a self-defense class, take some boxing, take wrestling, but never use that as your first resort. When people call names, you walk away. You walk away. I've been in a lot of bullshit high school fights, and what happened was I ended up being sent to a continuation school. And what that is you get sent to a fucking piece of shit high school where there's nothing but a bunch of fucking losers and gangbangers and a bunch of pregnant chicks. Because girls that, for whatever reason, I'm not sure why, there's a lot of moms sent to continuation schools because the hours are lower than a regular school. This might be a topic for another day. my time in a continuation school, but you're just kind of sent through. It's not really a good environment. It's sort of like a baby prison in a way. Point is, don't be like me and just learn to walk away from people who make fun of you for either your voice or the color of your skin or whatever. I know it's things that you learn on TV and stuff. Just walk away, turn the other cheek. Actually, turning the other cheek, I'm pretty sure that's something that is kind of taught to everybody, but that's what I need to work on. But for the most part, like now that I'm like kind of like a public person, I get a lot of, I do get negative comments and things. Just ignore it. Walk away. People do that in person. You can just, it doesn't really affect you. Words are just words. I think we're ready for something else because we've been harping on this for a long time. Do you got anything positive? Anything funny? We had a lot of comments, like almost 300.
Oh, well, before we close the topic, I was going to just say, so if you guys want to prevent racism or anybody feeling really bad, you have to be also the positive person. Don't make fun of other people for their race too and continue the cycle. So that makes less racist people around anymore. That's pretty much it.
Embrace people.
Mm-hmm.
Do it for love.
Gay for pay.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Sally's fetishes. You know what? I'm going to embrace it. Well, not like that, but I'm going to embrace it.
Embrace it with that booty. Okay, anyway. Jay Kwang Young. Jay Kwang Young asks, are you still doing game nights with your subs?
We all do that type of thing. When we can, when it's appropriate, when the timing is good. Twitter, Facebook, our social media things.
I'm making a Facebook right now.
A fan Facebook, yeah.
Yep, right now. So that whenever, okay? Because I get asked this question a lot, too.
But yeah, just so you guys, go look at the About section or, you know, wherever you see all the information of this YouTube video, and follow Mikey on Twitter, or Shidosha, or me, or, you know, everything. They always constantly post, like, especially Mikey, he always posts almost every day, if not, to play GTA, Call of Duty. I remember seeing a lot of Call of Duty Ghost, or Black Ops 2. It's no excuse. It's there. Mikey invites people.
Yeah, it's not just me. If you want to interact with somebody, the best way to do that is probably Twitter is number one, and then Facebook is second. Like, if I need someone to help me with a video, be like a test dummy to figure out a glitch, figure out a weapon's stats, and trust me, I will shout you out. I will put your Twitter or whatever in the description. If it's an open lobby, can't do open lobbies all the time. They're kind of chaotic. That's probably why a lot of YouTubers don't do them. They're definitely chaotic. But yeah, Twitter and Facebook and all that stuff. And you can see our streams, or if we need help with something or whatever, that's the best way.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. And I think we're ready. Yeah.
Next one. Jacob Morris asks, do you guys know each other in real life?
Hell no. Next.
I can't. I would never. Nope. You guys suck.
Fuck you. Technically, me and Shidosha met each other in real life first.
I got strong armed. She ain't really? Giving you the what whole, happened? She ain't giving you the whole answer. She strong armed me. Wait, I was in the airport.
Did you guys know each other beforehand? What happened?
Go ahead, tell us, Ally. Go ahead.
I think Shidosha does a better job.
Who knows? Who knew who?
Alright, so once upon a time I was on stage and Sally was like, oh, I hear a black guy. I should probably strong arm his ass in the airport next chance I get. And so that's what she did. She was like, she put a gun to my head at the airport. I don't know how she got that shit to the TSA.
Alright.
And then she was like, listen, you gonna be friends and we gonna talk next week. You know what I'm saying? Or I'll blow your brains out. I know where you live, okay? And I was like, yes, boss. And now we're on the podcast together. You know, it's all love.
During any of that, did she say, I feel sorry for your mother? I'm sorry. That was racist.
That was racist as well. Oh, shit. You
just killed Dosha.
Nobody knows what movie that's from. That's why it's funny. I know.
There's like 1% of that. Yeah, the kids do not know.
All right, if they know what movie that's from, just put the name in the description below. I want to see how many people know that movie.
Research. Someone's gonna do the for science. Yes.
I was gonna say that they'll probably say the comedy remake. Do you remember the comedy remake?
That was funny
as fuck too, dude.
Well, either answer counts because the same people were in that. That skit.
So really? Was it the same Asian woman?
No, I think the woman was different, but the man was the same.
They did a damn good job of replicating like that outfits and shit.
Yeah.
Okay. No, okay, but seriously, so when you first met, what, there was an arm wrestling competition?
Okay, so I kind of briefly knew who Shidosha was, especially since we were working at PAX together. I think PAX East the first time and
Prime the second.
Yeah, PAX East and Ubisoft was displaying their new thing called The Next Level, and Shidosha was one of the co-hosts for their Twitch channel, you know, esports casting.
Yeah.
And then...
For what game?
All games. All different Ubisoft games people competed in person. But anyway, that's not the whole point. I ended up at the airport, and for some reason, I saw Shidosha. And, you know, again, but I never really got a chance to talk to him. So, you know, I sat next to him and I think we started some little chat, but I don't know for what reason we clicked, I guess, in that small frame of time. Right, Shidosha? I hope I'm not...
That's the truth. That is what happened.
So why don't you explain from your point of view, not the gun point of view.
No. It wasn't... Okay, so yeah, I was working at the Next Level. She was at the Ubisoft booth. I think you were doing South Park at the time, right? No, you were doing Rayman.
Yeah, I think I was doing Rayman.
Rayman. I would creep over there. I would say hello to everybody. You know, just, you know, doing the PR stuff, shaking hands, glad handing and shit. Saw her. She was cool. Went at the airport, and I remember her face from the booth. And... I remember, hey, she's one of the less annoying people there. So, you know, I sat down. Now, she sat down. She said hi. I sat down. We chatted. And then some of her other fragdoll buddies who were also flying in New York, they kind of came around. And we were still just chatting. And then I don't know how she managed to get my phone number out of me. That was odd.
No.
I'm kidding. That never happened. No, yeah, Sally's back in, y'all. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. No, we were just chatting, and then we had some ideas, and plus we were all pretty much on the same team, so we just kept in touch, and yeah, now I'm here.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, we totally know Mikey. He's actually really that Doge dog that you see.
Yeah,
James. That's actually how Mikey looks like. That's his face. For all you guys who keep asking now, for his face, no kidding.
Now we'll meet up. Oh, I've been talking about like a Vegas meetup for a while.
I want to. That'd be cool.
That'd be fun. I've always wanted like organize like a YouTube meetup where a bunch of YouTubers go to Vegas and party and hang out with people. Like just we'll be like not even to like sell out and fucking promote the fuck out of it. Just like to be chill and have fun. Cause Vegas really isn't about gaming. It really isn't. It's about all kinds of other stuff. But we haven't met yet.
Mm-hmm.
So ready to. We've only answered 3 questions. That's kind of crazy.
That's pretty awesome.
All right, moving on. Tanner Lange says, what is your favorite Pokemon? I had to choose that one because you guys, come on, AlyMew.
Yeah, okay. So she's a Mew fan. Corny.
I love Mew.
Yeah, okay. I guess I like Polly's Whirl.
Polly Whirl.
Yeah, I don't play Pokemon. I like Polly Whirl because I had to, because I was dating this chick at a time and she was obsessed with Polly Whirl. And I bought her a big ass stuffed Polly Whirl and it ended up paying out in the end. So yeah. That's why.
Aw, it's kind of odd. Interesting.
I don't play the game, sorry. But what would you
Like the Mystic Bird, Zapdos to be exact. I'm an original 151 kind of guy.
Me too.
So you know, I mean, I like Moltres, I like Articuno, but Zapdos. That's just like the name Zapdos. It's funny.
Yeah, none of that makes any sense to me. But cool. What do you guys think about the Twitch Plays Pokemon? Did you guys check it out? Did you like it?
I did check it out. It's still going on. I think they're playing Crystal now, right?
Yeah, they beat, I don't know if it was Red or Blue they were playing. They beat that, and now they're on the Crystal. I have not seen how far they've gotten so far, but, I mean, collectively, it's coming together pretty well, so I'm glad to see it still going. As much as I was bashing it, like, I'm actually glad to see it going.
So what does it prove? That Pokemon just takes a bunch of random button mashing to eventually win?
I guess so.
I guess so. 'Cause
that's what it is. It ain't no Call of Duty game of skill. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. Oh, moving on.
I wonder how Pokemon would do with kill streaks.
Oh, God.
They wouldn't get a kill. I would like to see. No, I wouldn't. Call of Duty with everyone controlling it, that would be bad. That wouldn't work. Never mind.
Moving on. Yeah. Sean's. I don't know if I'm saying it right. Spaetzel says, "Hey, YouTube dude, love your channel. Got a question for you. My girlfriend's birthday is coming up, and I really want to get her something. Every time I ask what she wants, though, she gets really defensive about it and says she doesn't want one. What do I do in this situation? Do I go for the gift or get a card? Please help me out. Thanks."
All right. Do not give her a fucking card unless there's money in there.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Because
I say both.
I don't like gifts. I don't like gifts. Or gifs. No, I don't like that shit. Actually, I don't like anything when it comes to my B-Day. So, Sean, is your girlfriend, like, older or something? Because once you reach 21, it's like, yeah, you don't care about B-Days anymore. So, I don't like gifts and things. But what you could do, what is better than a gift and a card, is take her out for fun and do something fun. I don't know where you live. If you're, like, in Cali, it'd be like Disneyland. If you're in New York, night out in the town, you know, something fun, like a nice restaurant. And maybe a show or something. You know, that's what I'm thinking, like an experience. Invite some friends, like more of an experience thing than like a fucking gift. That's what I'm thinking. That would be fun. No.
Well, you do have a point. I think as the age goes up, the novelties change. Like, at a young age, gifts are cool. And if it was like a year, like maybe 15, 16, right? I would say get both. Treat it like a holiday. Get it like a Christmas. Get a gift with a card and write something in it. That's personal. That way they know it came from you, right?
Mm-hmm.
But then as you're older, fuck that shit. Just go out somewhere. They'll appreciate that more. You can pad it with a gift, but the experience itself is going to be more memorable. She's going to remember the experience when she looks at the gift more so than the gift itself. So, I don't know. Try that.
You know what was one of the best gifts I ever had was one of my girlfriends. She probably snuck into my phone. She got all my friends to meet up at a restaurant. And then we had a dinner at the Wolfman Puff?
Wolfgang Puck.
And that was... we ended up leaving the restaurant because his service was too slow. But the thought counted. And, like, all my friends were there. And I didn't have to pay for dinner. And, like, I don't care who you are. Like, a free dinner at a nice place is nice. So that was cool. So I would say that. Organize a thing with her friends. So get into her phone and invite all her friends to this restaurant next time. And I think that would be fun. Anyone?
I think no? so too. I'm gonna say I agree with you guys. Definitely, especially if the girl doesn't say she really wants a gift, you can have something small, like a rose, you know, just to pad it up a little bit. And it's nice to get a card because you can actually write, like, a heartfelt message. But I definitely think an experience is something that's more than just a gift. So I really think that's good. Or you can even cook her dinner, something.
Oh, right, that Shidosha? Right there. Yes, yes.
See, all right. I'm glad you're here, Sally, because I don't give a shit about cards, really. I don't like little material things. That's me, though. But you like them. You like those things.
I like seeing, like, you know, feelings being written out, because it's like, oh, wow, he actually took out the time to write me something.
Okay. Well,
right, it's not really about the card itself, it's about the message inside.
It's amazing, isn't it? Well, it could be in a letter. I don't even care.
Well, there you go. Ignore what I said and just listen to her.
No, but that it depends on you know, person to person, because, you know, Mikey is a different person, Shidosha is, and
I'm big on cooking. I like to cook.
See? Shidosha likes to cook, and, you know, wow, people, are you going to cook for me and Mikey one day?
No.
What?
You know, but you know what, though? So he wants to impress his girlfriend. Actually, if he fucking cooked a bomb-ass meal, I'm pretty sure that would impress her.
You know how much time that takes? Like, that would be great. They would love that.
She's like, I would love for a woman to cook something for me. Oh, my God. Yeah,
actually,
dude.
Another pro tip. This is what I learned. It's a friend of mine taught me this because he's a scumbag pickup artist. Okay, so if you can't cook... Try cooking anyway, but this is what you do. No, listen, hold on. This is what you do. Turn it into a cooking date. So instead of your traditional, you cook and then serve it, you guys just eat it together. Both of you spend time together in the kitchen, cook together, make that the experience. You know, fails and successes all together. And then whether it comes out good or bad, you guys bonded and spent, because that's the whole point, isn't it? The bonding process, all that other shit. You do all that together, and then that itself is the date, and then that's the experience. So if the food comes out good or bad, you don't have to completely take the blame either. That's what I've learned from when I made some nasty-ass lasagna.
That is a great idea. And that brought up another thing that's fun. I don't know if they have these anymore. There used to be this big thing called, like, paint by me or paint me. There used to be these, like, shops or places where you go in and you would paint your own clay and things, like paint your own stuff.
That's pretty cool.
I don't know if they have them anymore, but those are cool dates too. If you can go to one of those places where you can, like, make your own pottery and stuff.
I had a Build-A-Bear date. That was awkward.
A Build-A-Bear could work. You're taking out a 12-year-old. I'm fucking with you. Did we answer that? Ready for the...
I think we did. Yes, okay. We did.
You got a lot of fucking ideas, dude. What's next?
Okay. SD Knopf asks, question for podcasts. Which games are you most looking forward to in 2014? Thanks, Mikey. Love your vids.
Okay, it's our podcast. Titanfall, the Call of Duty killer. Oh, my God. No.
Hey, Game Bomb.
No, Destiny.
Is that coming out in 2014?
I think it is. I'm not. I don't even know. I think it's coming out next year.
I think it's slated actually maybe for November 2014. I don't want to be quoted, but that's what I feel like when it's coming out.
I'm looking forward to Destiny. It doesn't matter. The newest game I'm looking forward to is Destiny. I was looking forward, we're in 24, if you're asking about 2014, I was looking forward to Titanfall until I played it. Not anymore.
Dosha?
Yeah.
There's a few games I'm looking forward to. One is Destiny, the other is Watch Dogs. There ain't no Ubisoft plug. I mean, they do pay the bills. I love you guys, Ubisoft, but, you know, the little tidbits I did get this. I can't even speak. I did get to see. I liked. It looks like a fun game, and I'm really getting hip to games that use social media and mobile devices as units to play, and just it adds to the experience, so I don't always have to have the game on. The other game I'm looking forward to that nobody else probably cares about but me, but I'm a big Wolfenstein fan. One of my favorite games was Wolfenstein 3D for the PC, which is weird because I fucking hate Doom. Anyway, so there's a new Wolfenstein. I think it's called The New Order. That's coming out. I'm looking forward to that. I think that's for like PC, but big Wolfenstein fan, and I think Gearbox is making that.
Oh, that sounds different.
Yeah, so I'm a little hyped for that, just to see what Gearbox does with it. Hopefully they don't butcher it like they will. Duke Nukem was doomed to fail anyway. But I'm still hyped.
Hmm. Wasn't there... I thought there was a Wolfenstein, like, this year, though. I thought there was.
Yeah, there's a Wolfenstein coming out this year. I don't know the date, but yeah, okay. There's a new Wolfenstein.
They've been promoting it for a long-ass time, then.
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool. So you're looking forward to Wolfenstein, Destiny, like myself.
And Watch Dogs.
Yeah, I think I'm the same. Watch Dogs and Destiny. Watch Dogs, obviously, first, since it's coming out, I think, in May.
Someone left this comment. Is Watch Dogs a GTA killer?
Nope.
No.
Not in any way. GTA is an open sandbox world, okay? But Watch Dogs seems like more of a story, more in campaign. And I don't know about the multiplayer, but the campaign is just looked good to me right now.
Yeah. I mean, it's a big city. It's a sort of like a Chicago kind of, they've recreated Chicago in a way, but it's not really like GTA where you're just mindlessly killing everyone. So all right. So Sally, so you're just looking forward to
Watch Dogs and Destiny, of course.
Okay, so who's up next? Dino?
Is that who it is? I still can't say that name.
Okay, Mikey, go first.
DinoAtcher. It's like his website. DinoAtcher.
Oh, his website.
Oh, DinoCharter.
That's clever. DinoAtCharter.net.
This question is sponsored by DinoCharter.net.
Yeah.
Are you ever going to make a video that doesn't talk about porn stars? Should I answer this?
Yeah, go ahead.
We talked about this before. You asked for this. You do.
Yeah.
And we actually had a podcast where we did not talk about any adult-related content.
Yeah, no sports science section that time, okay?
And people got upset.
Yes,
and people said, did. What? No science? No adult stars? No nothing? But it just happened to be that way. And if these adult actresses put themselves in the news, then so be it. By the way, the Duke student... I approached her and I said, hey, we talked about you. You should come on as a guest. And she just fucking blew me off.
Oh, no.
I'm like, bitch, you know who the fuck I am? No, I'm just kidding. But I'm like, I have more Twitter followers than you.
For now. No, I'm kidding.
No, for now. Seriously. But I looked at her Twitter bio and she called herself a nymphomaniac.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that was like for... like promotional purposes or if she really is a nymphomaniac, but she's like it almost makes you feel like she just like totally puppeteered the media to get a big boost in all her things. I'm almost done caring about her,
I think at the time she probably didn't think about it that much, and you know, obviously brought that to surface, you know, that she's getting bullied. But at the same time, it plays good to her to have all this publicity. It's free publicity for her, free PR. So, I mean, she did mention that none of this would have been found out unless someone, you know, brought it up on campus. Someone found her Twitter account. Someone found all her other personality, you know, her made-up persona in the porn world. So, you know, that Twitter account that you're following is her porn persona.
Well, get it, girl. Get your Kim Kardashian on. I'll see you later. We're all rich and shit. Marrying Kanye's.
I know, right? Listen to all make a porn, you know, video and accidentally leak it.
Accidentally, quotations.
Mm-hmm. Nobody knew who... I didn't know who Paris Hilton was until she did her porno leak.
This is true. Same here.
And no one even gives a fuck about it
anymore.
Yeah,
not anymore.
I remember the day that the Paris Hilton porno came out... and Paris Hilton's in the news, and I thought they were talking about the Hilton Hotel in Paris. I had no idea who she was until she released her porno, and then of course I'm gonna be like, whoa, what's this Paris Hilton porno everyone's talking about? I had to go look it up because I had to do my research, even though I didn't have a podcast or a YouTube channel. And then I seen it, and then I'm like, oh, she's gonna make a TV series. Okay, I'll check it out. Like, it was brilliant, and she was one of the first people to do that. And then what do you know? Her friend Kim Kardashian does the exact same thing. And what's crazy is Kim Kardashian used to be Paris Hilton's sidekick. Mm-hmm. She used to be her fucking sidekick, and now Kim K is making way more money than Paris. She got knocked up by what's his name, so she's got all his money.
Kanye.
I can't blame him though, man. Kim's got that booty. Like, good lord. Jeez.
Man, it's just Photoshop.
Well, if you think about it this way, not only is Kim rich, her whole entire family is rich because of her too.
It's beneficial to both of them, actually. Mm-hmm. You know, and props to
that's because Mama Jenner's a pimp, though. Real rap. Let's be serious. Even the little baby Jenner's is getting pimped out now.
Yeah, they are.
Kim K, yeah, she was born into a wealthy family, but where a lot of wealthy people, girls or guys, would just like be happy with that, she took that shit to the next level.
And she made it into business.
She is a smart fucking woman, and she did a little bit of modeling. She had a TV series.
She's still an escort though. Like, why?
And she has her perfume. She's a businesswoman, dude, without a doubt. And she could have just laid back and collected all her dad's inheritance. But nope. Took it to the next level. So she's not as dumb as people think she is.
Yeah, oh, she's actually pretty smart.
She is smart. She's a beautiful woman. She got knocked up by, what's it? Kanye.
Mm-hmm. So I hate her.
I wonder if they signed a prenup. All right, fuck them.
I think they did.
No, okay. Well, this is going to be a topic for another day, but the prenuptial agreement they signed said something about Kanye. Kanye, he opted to give up $1 million for every year that they're together. Talk about a hustle. That is the stupidest goddamn thing you could do. Yeah, I got to find the article about the prenuptial agreement.
I want to say it's hard to believe, but Kanye says some stupid shit, man. He needs to just not talk outside entertainment. He is a fucking entertainer, dude. Mm-hmm. I went to one of his, he'd had a concert for one of the Call of Duty events, and that fool outlasted me. Like, I was tired of standing, because how long he went on, how long he was performing at, like, full force, and I'm like,
he's
dude,
a diva.
And I'm like, dude, I'm tired. He was performing all his hits, and they were banging, and he was just on fire, and I'm like, dude, I'm leaving, and I walked out. I couldn't hang with the dude. He is a fucking performer to the fullest. There's no doubt about that. He is entertaining. He's got some good music. He's got good, great producers, people behind him. But outside of that world, he just needs to just chill and shut up and quit talking.
Yeah, he's being a diva. He's a diva.
Wait. So what was the question?
Are you ever gonna make a video that doesn't talk about porn stars?
Oh,
you know what? Oh, I should also add. We also kind of get bugged because first we said that we get bugged because we don't make porn videos about porn stars, and then I read the comments. We also get bugged when we don't make videos about Justin Bieber either. He hasn't been in our headlines as of lately, so people were like, "Yeah, so when are you gonna talk about Bieber again?" I'm like,
"Well, you just brought it up. Wait, you just brought it up. Can I just say something? Did you guys see the video about him and Selena dancing?
Oh yeah, the dirty dance. Oh, they was getting in. No,
I didn't see it. What's that for next time? We'll mention I didn't see it. Who's next?
It's a good science video.
Who's next? This is a viewer's thing. What's next?
Austin. I think it's Austin Miller. When was the first COD game that each of you played? I think he meant to say what was the first COD game that we played. But yeah, that was it. So what was the first COD game you played, Mikey?
It was COD 3, and I didn't shoot people. I just used the vehicles. I used the motorcycle and the tanks, and that's all I did. I had zero gun skill. I said, fuck that. I'm using vehicles only.
Oh, sounds like a battlefield person.
Right.
And that's what that's the first one. I had no idea that there was even, like, YouTube channels for Call of Duty back then. So, yeah. What about you, Mew?
Call of Duty 4. That was my first one. I think that felt pretty late, because I know people were playing Call of Duty 3. I think I did pretty well, considering that I first started FPSs with Halo 3. And after Halo 3, I was like, I want a different game to play instead of this game every night. And I tried COD 4, and it was amazing. Dosha?
I'm not sure which one came out for consoles first. I don't know if it was 2 or 3. But I remember, I think it was one of those. And I remember getting it because I wanted to play this, like, a game like Medal of Honor. Back in the day, y'all remember Medal of Honor, Soldier of Fortune?
Yeah,
those were the crack right there. Oh, snap, I had to play those. So I needed another World War II fix. And Call of Duty, I didn't have a good PC at the time, so Call of Duty popped up. I think it was Call of Duty 2, and on consoles, and that was the one that I played. That's kind of what drew me to it. Yeah, you guys remember the old animations back when they used to like crawl, walk, and they used to just like bunny hop around like little idiots? My, how far we've come in our animations.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta find a video of that.
All right, who's next?
Atticus Reyes. Do you believe that there are civilizations of aliens way out there in space? Are they more or less advanced than us? Any thoughts on this subject?
Should I go first?
Sure.
Do it.
First part question. Yeah, duh, of course. Are they more or less advanced? Both. We've got primitive esque savage animals on our Earth, and then we've got brainiac, really intelligent creatures. You know, we've got a mixed bag, so it's kind of not fair to think that it's going to be just one way or the other somewhere else. But I refuse to believe we are the only life form in existence. That's kind of elitist of us to think. It's not fair. We should broaden our horizons. So that's my input. Going back to looking for a YouTube video.
Mikey?
Well, what does the Bible say about this subject? Nothing, exactly. No. The galaxy is a vast, vast place, and I would be very, very sad to hear that it's just us. But we did discover fossils on the moon. I'm pretty sure we did. No one knows. Okay.
I have no idea. I really don't remember that.
I'm 95% sure America did, the NASA did discover fossils on the moon. If not, I'm going to feel like a total fucking dumbass.
But well, there's also Mars, too, right? We're still looking for stuff on Mars, too. Let's not forget that.
If we discovered fossils, and I hope it was an article I read on a UK tabloid, I won't say the name of the website, although I like to visit it a lot. If that's true, if we found fossils in Duh, then that's a life form. That's a life form on a different place. And it's so vast. The universe is so vast. So yeah, I'm sure there's something out there. So yes, and then what was the second part? Are they more or less advanced than us? Fuck if I know. Hell if I know. If they're more advanced than us to reach us before we reach them, I'm afraid how our government would react. Like, I really hope they wouldn't be combative with them. Because if they can reach us before we can reach them, then they could probably just fucking shoot us with laser beams or something, you know? So, who knows? Who knows if they're more advanced than us? I have no clue. But I do believe there's something out there. Yes. A microbe to a full-on being? Yeah. I think we have time for one more, because we're going on 55 minutes here.
Wow, we did go through a lot of these. Okay, so the last I guess this last one is going to be from Atticus Reyes. Oh, wait, no, we already read that one. Oh, this one's directed to me from Cathal McStay. For me, what do I think is better, South Park, GTA, or Titanfall? What? GTA. South Park is cool. Titanfall is all right. GTA has the most replay value. That was a quick and easy question. Anybody else got anything to add to that?
But Titanfall's the Call of Duty killer.
So
I almost got 60. I almost got 60 kills in Titanfall.
Is it from farming the little minions as grunts and stuff?
That doesn't matter because that's part of the game. I got those kills. A kill is a kill.
Bell count.
All right, can I just say something?
Sure, I got 80 dislikes, the most of any video in my YouTube career, but those are 80 people that are mad that they just can't be on my level, yo.
I think they don't understand the point of Titanfall. To be honest, someone pointed out, actually, and also a couple other YouTubers that actually now are making only Titanfall videos, they all told me that you could literally just play the game and just farm these grunts and win the game for attrition because you're gaining so much points. It's more points than you just calling in your Titan and killing things, because if you're killing a lot more minions, you're getting a lot more points.
But that's part of the game. That's part of the game.
Yeah, it's part of the game.
What's to prevent the other team from shooting all the minions, the bots, whatever? If they don't like it, then they can kill the bots.
Mm-hmm.
That is how the game was built. And I do call my Titan. I just put him in guard mode or fall mode, whatever the fuck. And that game, my Titanfall gameplays get the most dislikes. And it's just people that are just mad because they can't be on my level. That's what I've come to the conclusion of.
Wait, Louis Quintanilla asked something around that level and is saying, you know, your videos are amazing. Are you going to upload any more Titanfall videos?
Not unless I break my record. So my last record was 59 kills, so I had to get 60 kills. And then 70, then 80, then 90, then 100 kill gameplay.
Need more bots, bro.
I need better competition, yo. I need more bots. Probably not. I like GTA and Black Ops 2 and Ghosts better than Titanfall. Sorry, that's just the way it is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's a fun game to play, but not so much fun to watch unless you're watching someone go beast and get, you know, a 60 kill gameplay.
You know, somehow I still find a way to get less than 20 kills in that goddamn game. I suck at shooters, man. I don't know what happened. Just don't know.
You just don't know how to use a gun.
For real. I'm good in the kitchen, though.
Make me a sandwich.
That was sexist. Stop it.
All right. So we're rounding up about an hour, but I think we decided that we should start using more viewer comments. So just leave a comment for the next time. Like, we'll have a little segment where we take a viewer question, because this is fun. We like what you guys have to say.
Yeah,
like,
awesome.
Guys, like we like. There was 300 question comments last time, and we only got through like what, 6 or 7. So that was pretty good.
Yeah, we didn't even get to ask the best one. How you get girls?
How you get girl? Next time we teach you how you get girl. So we have links to Sally's racist commentary and all her stuff, and Dosha, we have links to your ask, and we have links to everybody's stuff.
Mm-hmm. I thought you said links to Shidosha's ass, but okay.
You're a pervert, yo.
At least I'm an open pervert. The people who are
gay porn butt shots.
Wait. People who are perverted on the inside that don't say anything are the ones that you might want to be scared about.
Those are the ones I like because they always got that pair of handcuffs in the back of their purse or something. That's sexy to me. All
right. So, any closing remarks?
I'm streaming. I'm about to stream.
Good talk. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.